ブレイクダウンコアーティストの松田恵美です。今日の特集はリサローブ。ダラス出身で95年にデビューしたリサローブ、デビューアルバムのテイルズも大好評です。そして10月28日に発表されたアルバムファイヤークラッカーも絶好調な彼女にアニス君がインタビューしてきているので早速見てみましょう。インタビューの後には本当にエクスクルーシブです、リサのスタジオライブです。
Welcome to Japan.
Thank you.
Oh, is it your first time here?
No, this is my third time here.
Okay, so welcome back.
Thank you.
Did you have some free time to visit a bit of Japan or things like that?
Yes, the last time I was here, we went to some tourist places like Kyoto. Yeah. Uh-huh. And then we also went, I was pretty busy on tour. We went to Osaka and Nagoya and played a number of shows in Tokyo.
Which part did you prefer the most in Japan? Maybe Kyoto, isn't it?
Kyoto is really beautiful, yeah.
I think that it's a beautiful city too.
Yeah.
Could you tell us a bit about your new album?
My new album is called Firecracker. Mm-hmm. And it's coming out here in Japan 2 weeks before it comes out anywhere else in the world.
Yeah.
October 28th. Mm-hmm. And it's an album, it's really a collection of songs, and it's to me, it seems like a more intimate album than the last album, which is called Tales. Mm-hmm. And it's a lot of stories about relationships and love, and also stories about other people. Yeah. And the album is different from the last album, partially because it's more about the voice and about the songs. It's less of a rock band album, and also because there's more orchestra on this album.
Yes, I noticed it. You compose all the songs?
I composed all of them except for one called Let's Forget About It, which I wrote with Juan Patino.
Okay. Did it take you time, a lot of time, to compose all the songs?
Well, I'm always writing songs, so it's hard to say how long it took me to write them.
Okay.
It's really a collection of old songs and new songs, so it took, I don't know how long it took to write.
For example, when you started to record the album,
mm-hmm.
and you use the old songs. How do you choose them?
I choose the songs partially. My band Nine Stories, we play a lot of tours, and the songs that we were playing live, mm-hmm. that felt really good, we put those songs on the album. I put some older songs on the album that a lot of friends and audience people really kept requesting for me to put on an album. Mm-hmm. And then some songs I put on there, like the song I Do, I put on the album because I wanted an upbeat song. And so I wrote one at the very end of the project. I wrote specifically an upbeat song. Mm. So it's just a variety of reasons. It's like the songs that are ready are the songs that go on the album.
Do you arrange the songs too, or?
I arrange them, but then I work with my band, mm-hmm. and the other musicians that I'm playing with. Mm-hmm. And then we work with Juan Patino. Made the album together at his studio. Mm-hmm. He's a producer, and we all work together further to work on the arrangements. Mm-hmm. And then the orchestral arrangements on the album,
there's a lot of
those were written, the majority of them were written by a young composer named Dan Coleman. He's a classical composer.
Okay.
So it's sort of a less typical pop music. And then Juan also wrote one of the arrangements for the song Truthfully.
ねえ、リサローブ歌ってましたね。あのトレードマークともいえるあのメガネは本当にかけてましたね。なんとなくなんかこうダサ可愛いっていうか、だけどなんかこうギター持ってたりとか歌ってるところを見るとすごいキュートでね、なんかそこがやっぱり女の子にも受けるのかななんて思うんですけど、すごくやっぱり生の歌はいいですね。続いてはリサがメジャーレコード会社と契約する前にナンバーワンヒットとなったこの曲です。私も大好きです。リサローブ&ナインストリーズで Stay。
You did a, not did a movie, but you were in a movie,
mm-hmm.
and you did quite a funny character in it. You're a high school student or something like that?
Well, it's a movie called Serial Killing for Dummies,
yeah.
and I haven't seen it yet, but I play a high school student who is very depressed
yes.
and obsessed with Marilyn Manson, and it's a black comedy. It's about, it's a black comedy.
Did you enjoy it?
Yeah, I enjoyed it. One of the things I really enjoyed about it was we were at the end of making the album Firecracker, and I was trying to finish up writing I Do and a couple of the other songs. Mm-hmm. And it was great because when you're working on a film, you have a trailer, you know, where you spend
yeah.
time. And in between takes, I would get 10 minutes or 15 minutes throughout the day. And I was actually able to, like, write music on the set because there was no telephone and nobody could find me. It was, like, private time.
Oh, that's good. You can do two things.
Exactly. They help each other.
Yeah. Do you listen to your album when it's done, right after everything is done, or do you, like, take some time to listen to it when it's done, all done, all the album?
When it's all done, I listen to it a few times to make sure everything's okay.
Mm-hmm.
You know, make sure there's not a problem with the transfer,
mm-hmm.
but I don't really listen to it very much.
Mm-hmm.
except every once in a while if somebody else is playing it or if I'm at a radio station and they play a song or something.
Okay. When you record your vocals, what do you care most about? What do you care most about your vocals when you
Lately, I care most about telling the story and making sure it sounds very natural and intimate. And I'm also really into making sure it's in tune.
Okay.
I know some people don't care, but I like it to be in tune.
Mm-hmm.
And I don't know. Those are the things that.
Okay. When you compose with a guitar or piano?
Yeah, I compose mainly with an acoustic guitar.
Yeah.
Yeah.
That's great. What do you like the most about your job, like being on tour or being recording or being composing or?
I like being on tour. I like going to different places and, you know, different restaurants and meeting different people. I also like being in the studio sometimes because it's very focused and it's very goal-oriented, you know, you're just trying to make the song sound really good. Those are two things I like. But I also like live performance, because when you do live performance, it just happens once, and there's nothing you can do about it, and it's very, like, about the moment, getting it right.
Do you get nervous before the concerts?
I get nervous when I watch other people play, and then I get on stage, but it's just, once I'm on stage, I'm okay.
Okay. And something about your jacket, your album jacket.
Oh, yeah.
How did you find this picture?
That was a picture, we went to a vineyard when we were recording the album just to take a break.
Mm-hmm.
And we went back to there was a gallery in the vineyard and we went back and there were all these paintings up on the wall.
Mm-hmm.
And one of them looked like this one, only it had a different woman's face.
Mm-hmm.
And it turned out that the person who painted the drawing owned the vineyard. He's a 77-year-old man named Mark Miller.
Mm-hmm.
And he was a big illustrator in the 60s. He used to do illustrations for magazines back then, even like the Beatles and the Monkees and other bands. So we tried to get him to paint a new picture, and he doesn't do a lot of painting anymore, so instead we decided to change the face.
And, it's quite amazing. It's really beautiful.
Thank you.
Yeah.
It's actually a man's body.
I don't think so. Maybe mine.
Yeah, I think it's yours.
Yeah, I don't know. Maybe I look like that.
ね、どうでしたか、リサローブ。あのジャケットのね、写真っていうか絵もすっごい可愛くて、前回のテイルズの時のあのアルバムもすごい可愛いんでね、私お部屋なんかに飾ってるんですけど、意外だったのは彼女なんかこう髪の毛にメッシュとかね入れてましたね。それここがなんかちょっと意外だったんですけど、さらにそのリサさんからプレゼントをもらいましたよ。じゃーん。そのね、私も飾ってますこれ。CD ジャケットも同じねポスターなんですけれども、こちらにファイアクラッカーのポスターをリサさんが収録の後サインをしてくれたんです。ここに可愛い書いてあるんだけど、これをね皆さんにプレゼントしちゃいます。抽選で5名の方にリサローブさんのサイン入りポスターをプレゼントです。こちらの宛先までどんどん送ってください。番組へのご意見ご希望など書いてもらえると嬉しいです。というわけでリサローブの特集でしたが、ねえ可愛い人でしたよね。今日の特集を見てね、ぜひ会いたいっていう人はね、なんか年明け早々に1月にね、なんか日本でライブをやるみたいなんで、ぜひ私も行くんですけど、皆さんもぜひ行ってみてください。リサローブ特集の最後はブレイクダウンだけでしか見られないスタジオライブからのアルバム、ファイアクラッカーの新曲です。I do!
Okay, just start the song. When I'm done with thinkingThen I'm done with you. And when I'm done with crying, then I'm done with you. And when I feel so tired, then I'm done with you. You know, everybody feels this way. dance, not rain. And I get so frustrated, I stay up every night. And you ask me for an answer, and I'm so tired, and I'm up in the air, I'm up in the air. You know, everybody feels this way sometimes. Everybody feels this way, and I do. You can't hear it, but I do. And you can't hear it, but I'm feeling this way. Just because you say that I will be ignored, and I will be denied, and I could be erased, I could be brushed aside, and I will get scared, and I will get shut down, but I feel like I do because you push me around. I'm starting to ignore you, you know I've doubted you so long. I'm tired of overthinking, and I know you don't belong. And now I'm asking questions, no one pushes me around. Everybody feels this way sometimes. Everybody feels this way, and I do. You can't hear it, but I do. You don't seem angry, but I do.
I was really into early 80s, so Bryan Ferry was, I just think, he just had a way of making this, like, the sexiest funk. It was like, it was funky, but it had a tie. You know, fellas always want to know, yo, man, you know, what kind of tape can I, you know, hook up? So, because I'm gonna have this weekend. I always tell them, you know, get Gustav Mahler, the fifth, symphony that he did, the Adagietto. I just think it's the sexiest music. I mean, I always try to turn my people onto it. Just, you have to listen to this. You have to, I'm telling you.
Mazushii hitobito ya sensou de gisei ni natta hitobito ni ai no te o sashinobeta Princess Diana. Ano yasashisa, ano atatakasa.プリンセスダイアナは今も世界中の人々の心の中で生き続けています。イギリスのバラ、ダイアナよ永遠に。その業績を称えるダイアナ記念切手セットが発売されました。プリンセスダイアナの意思を汲み、収益の一部はエイズ撲滅基金に寄付されます。ご覧ください。プリンセスダイアナの光り輝く美しさ、人々を慈しんだ愛の眼差し、そして勇気を与えてくれた微笑み。今回は豪華な特製ホルダーに収めてお届けします。特別サイズの1枚を加えた7枚セット、卓上に飾っていつでもあの笑顔に触れることができます。さらにただいまご注文いただきますと、プリンセスダイアナを称えたメモリアルメダルも無料でお付けいたします。私たちに愛を教えてくれたプリンセスダイアナ、この記念切手セットはあなたのそばでいつまでも深い感動を与え続けてくれることでしょう。あなたの心に咲き続ける一輪のバラ、それはプリンセスダイアナ。